أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. My respected brothers and my sisters, today inshallah I'm going to share with you one hadith. This hadith is narrated by Abdullah ibn Salam رضي الله تعالى عنه, who was a Jewish scholar when Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم migrated from Makkah to Medina. And Abdullah ibn Salam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu says that I went to see Prophet, I was not Muslim up until that time, and when I saw his face, the very first impression I got by looking at his face was that this is not a face of a liar. He says, Abdullah ibn Salam, that the very first words I heard from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were, feed the hungry, spread salam, keep kin relationship, pray at night while others are asleep. This hadith actually has so many messages for us. You know, I want to connect this hadith with the message for Ramadan. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykum al-siyamu kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqoon. The purpose of fasting is so you may attain taqwa. What is taqwa? Taqwa is sincerity. Taqwa is my relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ikhwa, when nobody is watching me. Taqwa is presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my heart. Taqwa is that I feel presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7 around me. So taqwa is really relationship based on sincerity and purity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith has many messages. Before I will focus on the sincerity part of this hadith, see, this hadith has the best example how we should live our life as a Muslim living in North America. How should we live our life as a Muslim when we live in a country where we are in minority? Muslims are migrating towards Medina. Prophet advised them, feed the hungry, because when you feed people, it creates the atmosphere of brotherhood. It will make the hearts of the people soft for you. It will create friendly environment for you. The second thing he's saying is spread salam. Salam does not mean just the words. Salam means that whoever you are sending salam to, you are sending the message of peace and protection. The one you are sending salam, you are saying salam, he should feel protected. He should not expect any harm from your side. No harshness, no difficulty, no trouble from your side. So you will extend all the peace to that person, that brother. My brother, that is salam. And keep relationship, the family relationship, kin relationships. So this is very important for dawa purpose as well, for huquq al-ibad and dawa purpose, that we should maintain our relationships, our family relationships. My brother, let me go to the last part of this hadith, when Prophet ﷺ is saying that stay in prayer when others are asleep. When everybody else is sleeping and you stand for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that shows the sincerity. That is a reflection of pure intention, that you are doing this ibadah just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I said, taqwa is your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ikhwa, when nobody is watching you. That Allah is in your heart. Allah is with you no matter where you are. That is taqwa, that you are God conscious, that you have the feeling of presence of God with you 24/7. No matter if you are in your room and nobody else is watching you. You know, ikhlas is a gauge and a scale that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in the heart of every human being. And all our deeds will be weighed, will be judged on the base of that sincerity. My brothers And our sincerity can increase. That's why it is said, the reward in Ramadan of any fard deed could be 70 to 700 times, depending on our sincerity. So it's very important, my brothers, in Ramadan, fasting is really reflection of sincerity. Because nobody knows about fasting but you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See how careful we are. Even when we go in the washroom and we make wudu, we want to make sure that not a single drop of water should go down our throat. Because nobody is watching, but we have this feeling of presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is taqwa, that is sincerity, that is purity of intention. And this hadith basically is reflecting that in Ramadan, we should work on ourselves to make our inside beautiful. This Ramadan is to create relationship, to develop relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on pure intention and sincerity. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this tawfiq, that is in this Ramadan, we will be able to beautify ourselves. We will be able to make this relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on sincerity and pure intention, that we do what we do just for the sake, for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu Akbar.